So after I have drained off my old water, now I refill my pond with some fresh water. So after I refill my pond with some fresh water, make sure that you use untreated water. That is the water that is good. Mostly we prefer that you use borehole water, which has not any chemicals. So you fill your pond almost to half full. You should not fill it to full so that you avoid that overflowing. So here I am filling my pond with the fresh water. So I think this is at least enough, just to enable that my seeds will float. So after I have filled it with some fresh water, I add a blend of manure either by I have mixed in the ratio of 2:1. As I told you earlier, the amount of manure should double the amount of soil. So here I add my manure with soil gently. So distribute it evenly. Your water, to make sure that your water is fertile, as manure will fertilize the water and soil will add some micronutrients necessary for your azolla germination in the required time. After I have added my manure with the soil, I will come with my fresh seeds ready to plant into my pond. So I will just distribute my seeds evenly to the water. As you can see, the fresh leaves, the fresh seeds, how they look. Your azolla should be always green. So I distribute it evenly, whereby I expect in the next 7 days my pond will be ready for harvesting, and it will be have germinated all over my pond. So thank you for watching. This was just a brief introduction showing you how you can maintain your azolla pond for you to benefit with great harvest. Thank you for following us and liking our video. Remember to always to like our videos, to share and to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Welcome all to Jolly Farm.